thank you to be there.
For the last conference about solutions for creating a professional web application. So, for the context, we at the beginning of our adventure in Joomla, projects, our clients' projects were basic needs. And with the development of our business, most complex, much more complex needs are asked to us, so that Seblot grows. At the beginning, we were based on the CCK concept, and now it's just a part of what Seblot can do. So we try to introduce a new concept, which is Web Application Builder, because of the complexity of the websites we have to produce. And we have to compete with other solutions that Joomla. I think you know them, but we thought it was interesting to compare Joomla with the other solution we can find when we do business with Joomla. So who tried other CMS in the assembly? Who tries Drupal, for example? The last version? This year. We gotta consider 2012. Who tries Easy Publish? Just install it. Who try Concrete 5? Which is one we more and more popular in our country, in France. And who tries Seblot? Yeah! Thank you. Okay. For the scope, I gotta pass the relay to Sebastian.
Okay, so at first, sorry for my English, I am French, so it's always difficult. Okay, actually to build some application, the classical way is to use a direct programming language, like PHP, ASP, and GSP. Okay, and of course, now everybody uses some framework or platform or API. Today, all CMS, all the solution have this own API or other. Okay. The main disadvantage about this solution, of course, is time consuming, learning curves, and you must always reinvent the wheel each time. If you take, for example, with Symfony 2, a lot of guys use Symfony 2, but you cannot see any script which is published and given to the community in Symfony 2. So always all developers develop the same. Okay, so our purpose is to introduce the concept of WAB, Web Application Builder, for what, of course, to reduce time to product application and to allow you to reuse your work on any website and not to develop again the same things for any customer. So a lot of people think it's a dream, and we are thinking that it's the new way, and in few time all this solution will be more mature to use really. So I think it's the future. Okay, there is today a lot of application builder, and there is also some software to build some application. The software are developed with classic language, say C++, Java, and so on. There is AwareIM, NewBuilder, Zoho. This is the same. These three solutions do almost the same things. I will speak a little about AwareIM. It's a software written in Java. The good things with Java, it has a more professional image, and for big enterprise, Java is often taken. Okay, AwareIM is specialized to create what they call content-centric web application. And clearly, it's near the concept of content types. Okay, in AwareIM, they create what they call business object. So a business object is like a content type. And they define not field in business object, but attributes. Okay. But we can see that attribute is not really a field in the web concern. It's more like little feature that you insert it, but it's not a text area, a radio button, a checkbox, and so on. So all these solutions always cost money, of course, because it's a software. Many use licenses. It don't allow to work in real time. What you built with this software, you must then submit all your work in online in a website production. This tool relates often to the generation of specific applications to manipulate internal data of companies, which call this application database. That's why all these tools have no matters about publication and content display. So there is some other software which try to do the bridge between this software and some CMS. But it's only a bridge. Okay. This software are very old. So I think it's really the past. And the purpose is to do the same, and I think more directly on the web. Okay, so now we will see online solution to build web application. You know there is a lot. Okay, here we speak only about a few, but you can ask me after about other solutions, because we study a lot of it, and more than that. Okay, so about WordPress, who use WordPress here? Okay. So in WordPress, there is no content types concept. There is only a unique one content type. It's a blog content types. Okay. There is some feature about adding extra field. But when you define a field, in each content, you must select again which field do you want to use. So for each article, for each content, you select again some fields. So there is no clearly a content types definition. So it's very basic. Okay. And there is no search and no other thing included in the core. Okay. Typo3. Typo3 is a very new solution in France. It's not really a CMS. We say more this a portal. Do you know the difference between a CMS and a portal? A portal is more considered at the its managed page. And a page is all the content in one page. So in TYPO3, you can easily build a very complex page with a lot of content. But when you build a page, you must put all the content of the page. This is not like Joomla and other with module that a module you can call it in many pages. No, in TYPO3, you define again all content on your page. Okay, so there is some content elements in TYPO3, but this is not fields. It's a little application to do some specific thing. There is a very light form builder, but you can do anything with it. It's very basic. No content types. So you must, of course, like with WordPress and other solutions, when you have a specific need, you must code. Okay. And that's the same about the search. There is only what I call generic search. It's only one input text, like in Joomla. And you cannot do a search on a specific field. Okay, Conquest 5, manage page tips and allow the addition of attributes. Attributes are like fields, but there is only a few fields and very basic features. And a page tip, it's not a content types. A page tips in Conquest 5 is more the selection of the design of the HTML structure of your page. Like WordPress, all is done, and like Joomla, all is done around a unique content type, which is the blog content type. They include, like WordPress, a very basic form extension and some basic search feature. But like always, it's not enough to build some really web application without any code. Joomla and K2, a lot of people here know K2. Okay. K2 for me is more an advanced content manager than an application builder. There is a little part about CCK with extra field. Okay, so you can create extra field and assign them to a group, and then the group is assigned to a category. Okay, that means if you create a content in this category, you are only on one content types. That means you cannot store many different content with different content types in the same category. Okay, if I want to, in my category, store a recipe and an article, a classical article, I cannot. Okay. About form feature, K2 is very basic. There is not require field, they don't manage it, don't manage validation rules, and so on. And you will see then that we need all this to build some real application. Okay, and like you know, all extra fields are saved in JSON format in one field in the database. That means it's a good solution to display a content because you need only one query to require all the JSON content and to display it. So it's optimized to display one content. Okay. But then for all search features, it's not the good way because it's very difficult to search in a JSON string directly.
Okay.
That's why there is only basic search feature and not more.
Okay.
Are you agree with this because you know K2?
Okay.
Is publish is a professional tool with a big company behind, like in Drupal world, and you must pay. But it's a good tool. It manages class, and for is publish, a class is a content types.
Okay.
Defined by attributes, and attributes are the field in our content types. There is a lot of attributes, but like often, not in Drupal,
this is very basic,
and there is no intelligence in your fields. And the big problem too for is publish is the storage field value. They store all in one unique table. That means, imagine if you manage 20 different content types. When you want to do very quickly, your table will explode. So, okay, it's a good solution when you have a few content. In last year, they extend their notion. They speak about package, and now they call it content class export. It's only to export the object. So the object is content types, is the definition of your form.
Okay. So is publish
is not really a web application builder, but is in the way. They need to improve all such features. EZ Finder is good, okay, but the problem is always this. I don't know if you know, but it's always easier to store all your value in one table. To manipulate and so on is very easy. That's why a lot of solutions take this solution. But the problem is this, when you wish to manage a lot of content, it's hard. Pour en parler.
Okay, Drupal.
Drupal is really powerful. That makes 3 years that they work on a tool to try to build some custom application for customer. And that's why today Drupal is so used by some professional builder.
Okay, they have directly content types.
By default, you can see page and story. And clearly, when Joomla will use UCM and so on, if we have article, category, banners, web links, and so on, all this managed with UCM, and directly find this by default in Joomla Core, it will be a good point for Joomla in comparison of Drupal. And of course, Drupal, in Drupal 7, Drupal insert in the core the old CCK module. That's why we say today, okay, Drupal have its own CCK. And you can, of course, import and export your content types. But it's only about the definition of your content types, so it's a form.
Okay.
about how to store data. In Drupal 6, there was a separate table for each content type. And in the new release, they come back. And that's why, as I saw you, Edwin, you can to see and to heard all criticism and from Drupal community about this fact, because a lot of people say we have some problem about performance, and if we have a lot of content, it's a big matter. And there is the main developer of Drupal who has explained this, and he is agree, but with this structure of database, they have more flexibility about the search. Okay, there is another module very important in Drupal. It's the view module. View module is to build with an interface some search and list of content. It's powerful, but it's not in the core at first. Okay. And there is not really links between your view and your content types. I want to mean that there is no application concept. An application, you can think that this is always one or many content types, one or many search form and list. And you cannot, with Drupal, have an application with all these features in one file. So you cannot take your work and use it in other Drupal website. Okay. So in my mind, Drupal is very near the concept of web application builder. And in Drupal 7, they improve the SDK part in this direction. Okay, now in Drupal, you can manage your fields on your form, and you can manage your fields when for the display of your content. In Drupal 6, it was not possible directly with the interface. And this idea, I think, clearly, comes from all solutions on the Joomla world. Okay. So, Joomla and Cblood. Of course, we have form and content types. We have a lot of advanced features about the form, because when you want to build some advanced web application, you need this. List and search type, yes. We can compare our solution to the Drupal solution. There is some difference. There is something better in Drupal. There is something better in Cblood. For example, you cannot directly in Drupal do some join query between different content types. Not directly. In the search feature of Cblood, you are able to do some join query between different content types. It's very useful. Example, you have a recipe content type, you have a chief cooking content type, and for example, you want to search all recipe which have a cooking chief who lives in US. You can do this with Cblood directly on the interface. Okay. At the same way, it's very important when you manage a web application to control exactly what you want about your storage. Drupal don't allow all this. So in Zbloat, you are able to choose if you want to save your data of your content types in one table. This table is linked automatically with the comcontent.
Okay.
You can choose to store your data in JSON and in what you want, because it's only a plugin system. And today, we are able to save data directly in XML file and not in the database, or in a CSV file and not in the database. And in few times, we will add what we call the multi-storage. That means you will be able to decide for one field, I want to save the value in my table, in another table in JSON, in an XML file or other. And we are thinking that this is the best way to improve performance, because with this system, we will be able to use JSON storage to display quickly one content, and we will be able to use data table to search in it. So you have all the advantage. Okay, and at the same time, the purpose of Zbloat is to take the end of any extension. That means we are multi-object. Drupal manages only one object. It's content types object. But you cannot take the end of the user profile with the Drupal CCK. With Zbloat, we are able to manage the data of any extension. By default, when you install Zbloat, we manage article, categories, and user. That means, okay, you can do a specific form to manage the user profile, and so on. And like you know, another advantage of Zbloat about this is that we use only Joomla interface. So your customer is always in user manager, in category manager, in article manager. We don't develop the wheel because Joomla has this. Okay. And we have for our client, and we will publish soon, we manage to directly VirtualMart product, manufacturer, image media, and so on. Why? With this, so we can improve a lot all form about your product, and we can use all search features of Zbloat. That means you can build a very custom search directly on your VirtualMart product.
Okay.
We will show you just quickly three examples. Tu viens? Et on, tu vas switcher sur sur zip. Okay, just one example. We are on a production website. It's a big website. We will show you, there is a list of content types, very important. Just to show you one content types to see a little what you can build with Zbloat. That's why we speak about application builder and not only some extra field. In this example, Alex, can you go on form option? Okay. This is one content, and the user is able directly to choose some option of the contact form, which is inserted automatically at the bottom of the content. you can do something like this. Okay, it's in the administration side. Now we will show you another example on the site side. Donc tu vas sur le new simulation. Okay. I will let Alex to speak about this.
That's the project. Initially, the clients send us a .exe file and ask us to put it on the web. I suppose, as you can see, it was a bit complicated. And it can be compared to an Excel application. What the purpose of this application? Our client is a motor constructor. He upgrades the motor, and all these lines are car constructors, which are its clients, their clients. So this application is a financial simulator, allowing the investors to calculate their return on investment, considering the different scenarios of the future sales of all manufacturers, car manufacturers. So, if I choose a pessimistic scenario, all the data are preformatted in this way, and the result will be there, calculated with all these data. If I choose realistic, all data will be changed automatically, optimistic, and the most interesting, custom. For this one, the user can choose all these criteria. You can envisage different scenarios for each constructor. And you see, the result is recalculated live.
But Alex, you did a lot of programming on the template, right?
No, there is nothing about the intelligence of the application in the template, nothing. There is only the design. So, I can maybe show you after quickly in the administration. Okay, I will show you.
And just to for the end, you have the possibility to save your simulation and to make different ones, to edit it and to save again, and you have the possibility to have the history of your different simulations.
Okay. So, to answer you. There is no Ajax, only JavaScript. Sorry. Okay. So, this interface, what is it? It's only a form of SaveLoad. It's only a content type. This content type is called simulation. Okay, and we have two other content types. One to define a constructor, so our user can insert dynamically other constructor and define the value for each scenario. Okay, there is another content type here, which is called the company content type, which defines some static data about the company. So there is three content types which are called by the simulation content type. And I will show you in the interface to show you that there is no custom code.
You show the backend now?
Yeah, the backend. Vas-y, vas-y, mets-toi sur. So this this project use what we call the calculational future. It will be published in the next version. Okay. So I go on Cblend interface, form and content types. Like I said you, I edit simulation content types. It's a very small screen, so it's not very okay. Like you see, so of course in Cblend you can manage a lot of fields in only one form, and we code all to have a good optimization and to be able to do this. Okay, here you have an option, which is to define some calculation rule. Example here, okay, we can see there is an edit link, so there is a calculation rule. And it's very simple. Okay, you add any field from your content type, okay, or another field, a common field, possible too, is E, B, C, D, E, F, and so on. Okay, here you write simply your calculation rule, what you want, logarithm, exponential, and so on, so on. Okay?
That's coming to the next.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. It is.
So you use the on the template, like you have templates for Cblend.
Yeah.
You use the
we are in the Cblend template, the classic template.
Because you know that they have the barebone templates. CCK barebone.
Yeah, yes, it's from Unleash. Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
So you're not using
no.
You just the same.
We use in the main case Cblend templates. Just to say to other people which don't know Cblend, you have in Cblend directly a template framework. We can compare it with VARP, with Gantry, and other one. But it's only to manage your main content, not your Joomla website. And like you can see, you have a lot of solution with this template. But it's only an example. That's why Paolo speak about another template which is developed.
This one is very clean, doesn't have all those positions. And the CCK barebone doesn't have a position, you have to create manually.
Yeah, exactly. There is many ways to manage the design in Cblend. And to show you, for other people who don't know, two, there is another feature, and this is in the current version, which is called conditional state. So you can do any conditional between your fields. It's the same, it's very useful in many, many cases, and it's the same way, very easy. If I want this field, I can say, okay, it's very visible when I don't know. Article state is equal to publish. Okay. That's all. And like this, and you can do some things more complex and to say, okay, if the user chooses this value in this field, this other value in this other field, he will be able to see some other field, and so on. Okay, we come back on the slide. Oui, et non, et non, sur, sur, and just. Yeah. thank you. Just a last example on General Electric's website. It's just to show you about some search feature. In this website, there is some department homepage, and the purpose was to be able to build this homepage very quickly. Can you go on the top? We don't see the URL. Tu peux montrer la. Okay. Like you can see, there is only one value. It's the department. And with this value in the link, there is here a first search which search the introduction of this department. This is another search which search news for this department. This search and so on search all projects for this part for this department. Search for and so on and so on and so on. So we have in this page more search many search engines, and each engine are able to take directly the value on your link and to do the search.
So that's all module, right?
It's yes, it's a search called by the Cblot search module, search list module.
Okay. Come back to the slide. No. C'est bon? Tu te remets en. On a plus beaucoup de temps. Il est dans toi. Je dois passer à l'autre.
OK. So, what can be considered today as a WAB? The most solution which is near this concept is Joomla and Cblot. And in Cblot, you will see that you are able to export and, of course, import all your work about an application. And an application, it's a lot of content types, is a lot of search and list types. It can be too some module, some link in your menu, some category by default, and so on. When you export, Cblot exports these materials too. So the purpose not is perfect. We are working on it. The purpose is to be able to have an application out in the box and to install it everywhere. Okay, so I think really that we have at first the best architecture in Joomla. We are alone with this and this. Object-oriented programming, really, Drupal is only function, is the hallway. And we have MVC too, Drupal not, and other solution not too. Okay. So, Joomla plus Cblot, we have a very powerful, flexible solution for professional needs. That's why I say Joomla is a professional tool to answer the most complex needs. We do this to try, because we have the issue, to try to change some image about Joomla. If my mind, I think, I am happy to see some people. You know that WordPress have a big public. It's few professionals, a lot of amateurs. Drupal has a lot of professionals. Okay. And I think, and Joomla is between. I think we can do the difficult operation to be for the end user, amateurs, and to be for the professional. So that's why we try to communicate on the other side too. Thank you.